Very much, Mr. Chairman. So today I would like to present my study, the incidence of reproductive disorder in dairy cows under smallholder farms. So these smallholder farms. And then I belong to the Faculty of Animal Science, Hasanuddin University, Makassar, Indonesia. Yeah, introduction. As we know that reproductive disorder in dairy cattle, this is a great problem to the producer, even large farm, as well as also small farm. And then, if this occurs, then reduce reproductive performance by extending the interval from calving to conception and subsequently prolong calving interval. And then this also will increase the number of surfaces per pregnancy, reduce milk production, and finally, economic loss. So that's why we need efforts to improve the reproductive performance by this reproductive disorder. So the objective of this study was to know the incidence first, because this smallholder, so we have to know first the incidence of reproductive disorder and then the types of reproductive disorder. In this study, we use 12 small farm, this small farm. So I emphasize this small farm. And then, you know, herd size is only 2 to 19 cows. And then housing system, all tie stall. And then we use also 51 cows and 29 dairy heifers. And milking for the cows twice a day. And then feeding, traditionally, the farmers use elephant grass and some other natural grasses, and then some rice bran. Sometimes they use also mineral and vitamins. So in this study, because this actually preliminary study, because the dairy cows, dairy farm in our state, so just now develop it. So first we did clinical reproductive examination by palpation per rectum and also vaginoscopy. And then we try to find the abnormalities of reproductive organs, and then we define that if there is a reproductive disorder. And then first, this shows the pregnancy status after palpation per rectum. And then we found that this pregnancy of the heifer and then the cows. Actually, we didn't have intention to compare this between heifer and cows, but just to show that the that time when we examine the cows and the heifers, the pregnancy goes like this. And then this shows the body condition score, reproductive performance, both dairy and dairy cows, and then also dairy heifers. Body condition of the heifers is 3.02, and cow is 2.88. And then actually, by statistically, not so significantly different. And then the interval for the heifer from 2.75 to 3.5, but the cow is a little bit from body condition is lower, 2.25 to 3.5. And then we also noted that the interval from calving to conception for the dairy cows is 217 days. With the interval from 69 to 369 days. And then the surfaces per conception, 1.6 for the heifers and then 3.4 for the cow. And then this significantly difference between these cattle. And then we expected that calving interval for the cow is more than 500 days, with the interval 366 to 867. And this the days to conception of the dairy cows, and then we can we know that greater than 210, so 55% of the cows conceive after 210 days. The other is less than 50%. So this, I think, this problem for the small scale, and then this actually we need to improve later. And this shows the type of the incidence of reproductive disorder. So we found that inactive ovary, cyst, uterine infection, urovagina, and then in dairy cows. So actually, the average is 10 for inactive ovary, 5 to 6 for the cyst, and then uterine infection 12.5, and urovagina 2.5. And then this a little bit strange, because uterine infection is occur in the dairy heifer, a little bit greater than the dairy cows. And for the future, so because high incidence of reproductive disorder we found in this study, so we need to solve this problem for the future. And then this, all the causes actually were not fully understood, but this we will find later. And then we hypothesize that management factor, including reproductive management, are predicted to be the main causes of this problem. So to achieve high reproductive performance and to reduce the incidence of reproductive disorder for this small farm, so it is necessary to find the risk factor affecting this condition. First, management approach, including reproductive management, is the first priority to overcome the this situation. And then also application of better management practices, including housing system at the farm, would to reduce the incidence of metabolic disease. As conclusion, that high incidence of reproductive disorder in smallholder farm was noted in the current study. And then the occurrence of reproductive disorder decreased the reproductive performance of the cattle in smallholder farms. This is all my presentation. Thank you very much.